हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ द मॉड्यूल 3 ऑफ चैप्टर 5 वेजिटेशन एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ ऑफ इंडिया एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द वाइल्ड लाइफ इन दिस मॉड्यूल और इन दिस वीडियो. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस द वाइल्ड लाइफ एंड द डिफरेंट स्टेप टेकन बाय द गवर्नमेंट to improve the condition of wildlife as well as vegetation. Wildlife of India. First of all, we should know the importance of wildlife. Wildlife help to maintain ecological balance of nature and also maintain food chain and natural cycles. It has economic value. Many wild plants provide useful substances like timber, paper, gum, milk, etc. And they also have provide a wide application in Ayurveda and other branches of medicines. While animals' products are tusk, ivory, leather, honey, etc. So in this way we can say that wildlife is very important. Another task that some wildlife or animal also help us to pollination of the crops and fruits and other things like milch animal give us milk as well as meat, eggs and help us in the transportation also. So in this way we can say that animal help human being in different forms. Every species has a role to play in the ecosystem, as I explained you just. So there is a needful step we should take to conserve these species. So let's find out the different wildlife in India and the major threat to these wildlife and the steps taken by the government to improve the condition of these wildlife. Wildlife in India. India has more than 89,000 animal species. India mein 89,000 se bhi jyada type ki animal species milti hain. In India, like the elephant, most majestic mammal. Elephant ek mammal hai. जितना बड़ा इसका शेप होता है दैट्स वाई इट्स कॉल्ड एज मेजेस्टिक मैमल आर फाउंड इन द हॉट वेट फॉरेस्ट्स ऑफ आसाम. आसाम के हॉट और वेट यानी कि ट्रॉपिकल एरिया में, ट्रॉपिकल एवरग्रीन फॉरेस्ट एरिया में ये मिलता है. आसाम, कर्नाटका एंड केरला. देन वन हॉर्न और राइनोसोरस इज अ स्पेशलिटी, अगेन स्पेशलिटी ऑफ आसाम. Live in swampy and marshy land of Assam and West Bengal. There are two area of the Assam and West Bengal. So the first and important swampy area of West Bengal, that is Sundarban Delta, and another, that is the Assam area. So one horned rhinosaur is the specialty of especially Assam swamp area. Swamp area is tidal area also, we can say the marshy area. Arid area of the run of Kutch. Run of Kutch exists in Gujarat. So, jo dry area hai Gujarat ka and the Thar Desert part of Rajasthan are the habitat for wild ass and camels respectively. The run of Kutch jo Gujarat mein hai aur Rajasthan ka Thar Desert wild ass aur camel ke liye important hai. Indian Basin, Nilgai, Chausinga, gazelles and other man animal also we can found here. India is the most, or we can say important country for the lions. So we can say that India is the only country having lion and tigers. In other country also there is a lion and tigers, but it is important for Asiatic lion. Only Gir forest is provide a natural habitat for the एशियाटिक लॉयन. और गिर ही एक ऐसी जगह है, गिर फॉरेस्ट, जो गुजरात स्टेट में है. एशियाटिक लॉयन के लिए, सिर्फ एशियाटिक लॉयन यहीं पर मिलता है. Tigers are found in the forest of MP, Madhya Pradesh, and the Sundarban of West Bengal. Sundarban Delta, as I explained you just, West Bengal ka Sundarban Delta Royal Bengal Tigers ke liye bhi bahut important aur famous hai. Ladakh, freezing cold, and this is a cold desert also. Ladakh jo bilkul freeze aur cold desert ki form mein important hai, a home for yak. The shaggy horn wild ox and the Tibetan antelope, the barrel wild sheep and the kyang, the ibex, bear, snow leopard and the rare red panda also found in these areas. In the river area or the lake or the coastal area, there's a turtle, different kind of crocodile and gharials also found. So in this way, we can say that there are number of species we can found in form of insects, animals in India. But these animal also facing different kind of struggle, or we can say that some species also mentioned at endangered species. Some of species, like more than 20 species already extinct, and some are near, or we can say on the door of extinct. So what are the causes which give a threat to this flora and fauna? Every species has an important role in the ecosystem. I just explain you ki har, chahe wo plant species ho ya koi animal species ho, har kisi ka ecosystem mein apna ek important role hai, jo role us ecosystem ke functioning ko complete karne mein help karta hai. So the conservation of flora and fauna, flora as you know the plant species and fauna as you know the animal species, is essential. यानी हर काइंड के फ्लोरा का और हर काइंड के फोना का एग्जिस्टेंस बहुत ही इम्पॉर्टेंट है, एसेंशियल है. अबाउट 1300 प्लांट स्पीसीज एंड आर एंडेंजर्ड एंड नियर अबाउट 20 स्पीसीज आर एक्सटेंट. एक्सटेंट मीन्स दे हैज़ गॉन, गायब हो चुकी हैं. और 1300 के आसपास वो है एंडेंजर्ड, मीन्स दे आर जस्ट एट द डोर ऑफ एक्सटेंशन, यानी दे आर नियर अबाउट टू एक्सटेंट. The main cause for this major threat to nature are, in sub threat ke piche ya endangered or in species ke extinct hone ke piche jo major causes hain, jo karan hain, these are the one and the important, that is the hunting for commercial purpose. This is also called as poaching. Basically yani commercial purpose ke liye, self nest ko complete karne ke liye jo trees ki और एनिमल्स की हंटिंग की जा रही है, दैट इज़ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट कॉज. नेक्स्ट, पोल्यूशन ड्यू टू द केमिकल एंड इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट. एज यू नो दिस इज़ द एरा ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल डेवलपमेंट. इस इंडस्ट्रियल डेवलपमेंट के एरा में देर आर नंबर ऑफ इंडस्ट्री एग्जिस्ट एंड नंबर ऑफ इंडस्ट्री अबाउट टू इन एग्जिस्टेंस. बहुत सारी इंडस्ट्री बनी हुई हैं जो वर्क कर रही हैं, और बहुत सारी इंडस्ट्री इस क्यू में हैं कि कब वो अपनी फंक्शनिंग और वर्क स्टार्ट करें. सो दे क्रिएट अ पल्यूट एटमॉस्फेयर एंड दे आल्सो थ्रो अ बिग ह्यूज ऑफ केमिकल एंड इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट. सो इन इंडस्ट्री का जो केमिकल और इंडस्ट्रियल जो वेस्ट है, वो लैंड के लिए भी एज वेल एज एनिमल के लिए भी बहुत ही हार्मफुल है. नेक्स्ट, rapidly cutting of the forest for cultivation and habitation. As you know, the root cause for all problem is the population explosion. जो population हमारी explosion form में बढ़ रही है, जो increase हो रही है, इस increasing population के लिए we have to give the habitation. हमें घर provide करने पड़ेंगे and we have to feed them also. उन्हें हमें feed भी करना पड़ेगा, so we have to cultivate the land. So the major cause that we converted the forest area into the cultivated land. यानी हमने forest की जो land है उसको cultivated land में यानी farms में convert कर दिया है, जिससे different animal और plant species के जो natural habitat हैं, natural habitations हैं, जो natural घर हैं, वो बर्बाद हो गए हैं, ख़त्म हो गए हैं, and that's why they at the door on the extinction. So we need to conserve the animal, means we need to conserve the flora and fauna, and our government also taken many steps in this way. So let's read the different steps taken by government to improve the condition of flora and fauna. Government established 18 biosphere reserves for the development of different plant as well as animal species. Then also from 1992, they provide financial and technical support for the botanical garden. Then government also established different projects like Project Tiger, Project Rhinosaur, Great Indian Bustard, these different projects. Then government also established 105 national parks. This is according to the updated number of 2020, yani latest version ke according, latest updation ke according mention hai 105 national park and 551 wildlife sanctuary are set up to take care of the natural heritages. And also government to protect the flora and fauna also establish a Wildlife Protection Act was also implemented in 1972. In 1972 में ही wildlife को protect करने के लिए Wildlife Protection Act भी government ने implement कर दिया है. 1972, this is the important date, need to learn it. And in this way, the government also set up the 18 biosphere reserve, which we already discussed. So let's see the 18 biosphere reserve and their areas. First, coal desert of Himachal Pradesh. Second, in Nanda Devi at Uttarakhand. The third one is Kanchenjunga at Sikkim. Fourth one, Dihang and Dibang in Arunachal Pradesh. You can see the beautiful scenery of these biosphere reserve. Then fifth one at Manas. The name of the biosphere reserve is Manas in Assam. Then sixth one is Dibru-Shikowa at Assam also. Next, Nokek, the seventh biosphere reserve, Nokek in Meghalaya. Panna, 8th one, Madhya Pradesh. 9th one, Panchmadi, also in Madhya Pradesh. 10th, Achanak Mar Amarkantak, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, in two states, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. Then Kutch in Gujarat, as I explained in the this initially video, that Kutch, Gujarat or the arid area of Gujarat also famous for the wild ass. So it is a wild ass. Then Simlipal at Odisha. You can see the beautiful scenery of the Odisha, Simlipal. Then Sundarbans Delta at West Bengal. This is very important for the Royal Bengal Tiger. Then Seshachalam at Andhra Pradesh. Agastya Malai, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Kerala. These are the Nilgiri Hills. Nilgiri, Tamil Nadu and Kerala. Gulf of Mannar at Tamil Nadu. This is Gulf of Mannar. This is a some water kind of reserve. And this is also famous for Dugong Dugang. Then the 18th, Great Nicobar exists in Andaman and Nicobar. This is the location of different biosphere reserve state-wise in India. So this is the completion of the chapter of natural vegetation and wildlife. Thank you.